The Green Bay Packers have signed Treyvon Hester, the infamous man behind the Cody Parkey double doink. Even if he never plays, this is the greatest signing in Green Bay Packers history. Grossi Posse Packer Nation! Welcome to another episode of Packast, the podcast where you don't have to be a Packers fan, but it sure does help. I'm your host, Tom. You thought the double doink went away, didn't you, Bear fans? Grossi! And yes. Oh, yes. I can't say I'm actually excited for the player. This is more of a depth move, but good God. This is great. This is just great. Before we break down Treyvon Hester, I want to do a big shout and thank you to some brand new patrons over at patreon.com/TomGrossiComedy. We got Dr. Link. I never knew he was a doctor. We got Nolan Moore or Less, and then Kevin Hanoran. Thank you very much to the three of you for joining and supporting me over at patreon.com/TomGrossiComedy. It is much appreciated. We have talked about how the Green Bay Packers needed to address the run defense, and I mean, this goes away to doing it. Sure, it's another body back there. I think it's going to be more competition for camp. But Treyvon Hester is a fourth-year player. We already mentioned, obviously, he was from the Double Doink. He's just got a little bitty finger on the Cody Parkey kick. He's a seventh-round Raiders pick in the 2017 draft. I didn't see anything about his contract yet, but he's paid $645,000 by the Redskins last year, so I have to imagine we got him for pretty cheap. He's appeared in 41 games over the past 3 years, but only has been started twice. In 2017, he had a forced fumble, 9 solo tackles, 1 tackle for a loss, and 4 QB hits. While in 2018, while he was on the Eagles, had 1 sack, 8 solo, 2 tackles for a loss, 3 QB hits, and 1 double doink cause. And then 2019, 1 fumble recovery, 1 sack, 2 solo tackles, 1 tackle for a loss, and 1 QB hit. So, again, you know, looking at this, he actually didn't start a single game in 2019, but he played in 15 games. So that's why I'm kind of just saying, yeah, he's going to be a depth signing. I don't think it's necessarily a bad signing, but I think that this is going to provide not only competition for camp, but it also could help in the run defense. I was looking at some of his stuff, and it seemed where he was the most productive was in the run game. So I like the pick. It's super duper cheap. I would imagine we could potentially go for somebody else to bring in, potentially, like Snacks, but at this point, we don't know. Then, over on the other side of things, on the offensive side of the ball, yep, we're going to talk about this. I'm going to nip this right in the butt before it could even occur. So, the Titans decided not to give extension to Corey Davis. They did not pick it up. The 5th overall pick from the 2017 draft. Oh, looks like first round wide receivers don't always pan out. Don't worry, I'm going to have a whole video rant on that probably next week. Now, this, I want to make this very clear. He's still on the Titans. He still has a year left. For the Titans, it makes no sense to trade him unless it's a ridiculously good offer because they get to keep him on a super cheap contract as a prove-it year. They obviously have A.J. Brown. They have Humphreys. And so we're going to kind of see if Corey Davis can do anything. I mean, honestly, what would you give up for him? A fourth for the potential? And then if he does well, you're going to have to pay him a buttload of money next year. But 2017 played 11 games, 65 targets, only 34 receptions, 375 yards, and 0 TDs. 2018 was his only full season, had 112 targets, but only 65 receptions, 891 yards, and 4 touchdowns. That was his best year. And in 2019, played 15 games, 69 targets, with 43 receptions, 601 yards, and 2 touchdowns. So obviously, there's concerns. He's obviously not lived up to his former fifth overall pick standing, but I think if he was a free agent this year, I think you sign him to a cheap contract just to see what happens. But in this case, I honestly just don't feel comfortable trading for him because we have no idea what we're getting, and I don't want to potentially spend draft capital that we won't use on a wide receiver next year because I don't want to get my hopes up. So yeah, Corey Davis just doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. And another question real quick, I'll nip this in the butt too. Percy Harvin, I know he wants to come back. I've gotten a lot of messages about Percy Harvin. number one thing wrong with him was injuries. Obviously, guy was super duper fast. He had that speed, but he's another one that it's a high risk, but it's also, you know, you're probably not going to pay him a whole lot. So I would feel more comfortable bringing in Percy Harvin. Oh, I don't know how durable he would be because he hasn't played football in a while. Then Corey Davis, because we would have to trade for him. So no to Corey Davis. Treyvon Hester, it's depth. I think we still got some work to do. I still think it's possible that we go out and get another wide receiver, maybe like a Taylor Gabriel. I still think it's possible to go out and get another defensive tackle. With what money? Yeah, who knows? We're probably going to just have to make some cuts at one point, but that's how I'm feeling about it. But let me know what you think down in the comments below. You can always find me at TomGrossiComedy.com or at TomGrossiComedy on all social media. See down below. Check out Packast on SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play Music, Spotify, and of course YouTube. And a big shout and thank you to all the Patreon members over at Patreon.com/TomGrossiComedy. But thanks so much for watching. I'm Tom Grossi. And as always, go Pack, go.